Find out more. For this video, I will be using your Ready 5 Mathematics Instruction Book, page 63. In the previous video, you saw that 6 times 8 tenths equals 4 and 8 tenths. How is that related to 6 times 8 equals 48? Notice that the digits of 6 times 8 tenths are the same as the digits of 6 times 8. The digits of their products are also the same. The decimal points are really the only difference. And of course, that makes them different values. In earlier lessons, you learned that dividing a number by 10 shifts the decimal point to the left, so the value of the number decreases by a factor of 10, like this. 8, or 8.0, divided by 10 equals 8 tenths. So, dividing by 10 decreased the value by 10. Notice how the decimal point shifted one place to the left, 8.0 to 0.8. Dividing a number by 10 has the same result as multiplying the number by 1/10, or 0.1, like this. 8 times 1/10 equals 8/10. Both of these resulted in the same product of 8/10. Think about that as you look at the next part here. Look at this table to see patterns when you multiply numbers by 1/10 and by 1/100. Let's take a look. Let's start with 6 times 8. 6 times 8 is equivalent to 6 times 8 times 1, or 1.0, and it's also equivalent to 48 times 1, or 1.0. So of course the product would be 48, or 48.0. Let's take a look at another expression. How about 6 times 8/10? Again, the digits look pretty similar, right? This time, the 8 is in the tenths place. There's a decimal point involved, and a 0 in the ones place as a placeholder. Equivalent expressions to this would be 6 times 8 times 1/10. Or 48 times 1/10. The product for this, watch the decimal point here, 4 and 8/10. The difference here so far is that the decimal point shifted one place to the left, because in this latest row, the digits were being multiplied by 1/10. And finally, 6 times 8/100. This again will look similar to the others. 6 times 8 times 1/100 is equivalent to that. So is 6 times 8 times 1/10 times 1/100. So is 48 times 1/100. And this is also equivalent. 48 times 1/10 times 1/10. 48 hundredths, or 0.48. And finally, take a look at this. 8/10 equals, or can be broken apart into, 8 times 1/10, right? Following this same pattern, similarly, a hundredths decimal, such as 8/100, can be broken apart as 8 times 1/100. And also, 1/100 can be further broken apart as 1/10 times 1/10, because remember, 10 times 10 equals 100. Just like 1/10 times 1/10 equals 1/100. Good job.